The copy tree tool in SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard enables entire designs to be copied and file names changed easily. It allows the updating of metadata to happen automatically, while also having the ability to find and replace parts of folder or file names. If we take a look in our local Vault view, we can browse to the design that we want to copy, select it, and use the copy tree command. We could use pack and go inside of SOLIDWORKS, but then we're potentially duplicating files, and we'd have to manually deselect all of the components that we don't want to copy, typically those are fasteners and standard library components. So within our PDM administration tool, we're able to set up on a per user group basis the ability to exclude certain folders of data from copy tree. So any files located in those folders are never copied. As you can see here, the administrator has excluded this component automatically, so we don't duplicate these files. We have the destination path for each file and file name, or we could simply browse and specify the destination location for all copied files. Once we change the destination path, we can see the file paths update, but the file names remain and therefore warnings appear. We don't allow duplicate file names in our vault, so we need to give the new files new names. Under Transform Operations, we have the ability to apply a prefix to the file, or we could add a suffix, or we have the Replace command, where we can replace one file name with another. We're going to look to replace the component called Lens with Lens Cover, so we can use Find and Replace, and that will go ahead and change the target file name for us. Alternatively, we can add a suffix to all of these files, which is Mark 1 in this case. We can see that the locking pin has been excluded from this list. We have a number of options that we can use when performing copy tree. We can include simulation results, name drawings after their models, and also preserve relative file paths to maintain the folder structure of any files stored in subfolders for the copied dataset. And finally, we can check in these files automatically, assign a comment, and then copy the design. Once the design is copied, we can now browse to the copied design and we can see all of the files that have been copied within the contains list. However, the locking pin is still referenced in the standard library folder as this was excluded within the administration tool when using the copy tree command. If we take a look at the folder card, we can see that the project information has been updated based on the folder the files have been copied into. So we can have metadata being pulled automatically through to the copied files, and we can also see the file names on the file cards have been updated. Within the administration tool, we can also set some options regarding properties when using copy tree. So we can decide exactly what metadata we want to clear, so we're not copying existing properties from any files. We could also assign default values to the files automatically, so that when the data is copied, certain properties are cleared and others have set values assigned to them.